Hi guys, this is Oli Wu with the next part of the instrument style tutorial. We're continuing from our last session. This time I hope that everything is fine. I really try to freeze the brightness here so it doesn't flicker, and hopefully you can see the contrast and these buttons lighting up, and also create a little bit more light here. So, and I try to remember to really push on my screen where the display is, so hopefully this will be also a lot more in focus than especially in the last part, so apologies for that again. Had a really good question from one of the viewers, Simone. Thank you a lot for asking this question. And the question is, now that we're back in our tutorial, I selected the registration, and when we play back the style, then why is everything out of tune? And that's an awesome question. Before, remember, we just had drum instruments, and drums, by definition, they don't really change their tuning when we play with the left hand different harmonies, because otherwise we would get different sounds. Like the kick, for example, is on the C, and the snare is on the D. So if that would transpose for drums, then that wouldn't be good at all. Interesting, maybe, but not what we want. So let's just start slowly and take a little bit of an excursion into playing back the style, although we're still working on it and building it up. But, you know, it works differently in the style creator. We're always basically pretending almost to press C major. We don't press it really, but we click start and stop, and just inherently it will always play it back on C major. And here, if I'm in my normal registration, I can tell you that my right 2 sound is on. You can also see it here. That's the strings. Haven't used that sound, but it just happened to be in my registration here. And we'll talk a lot more about setting up the actual sounds for keyboard playback in addition to styles and songs later. That'll come later, but just for now, bear with me. So here's my strings. Also, I can tell you, you don't see it, but on this side, the accompaniment button, the one that's just on top of the intro one part, ACMP, accompaniment, is off. So what happens, if I play in this left side, and again later I will show you, I mentioned that before, how to split your keyboard properly, but I think the default split is somewhere around this G or F. So normally, when I play here, we should see chords being recognized. We should maybe get the style triggered. Nothing is happening. We're still playing the same sounds. I showed you that, I think, in one of the early tutorials. If nothing else is on and I have only one sound selected and no left sound, we're just playing the whole keyboard with strings. If I was gonna select the left sound, actually, looks like the split point goes to the A. So this is our left side. Usually the left side, where the left sound plays, is also the part that triggers the harmonies, but also that can be configured. But as a general rule, this is roughly where we're playing left sound and triggering harmonies. And then you can see with the left sound, and we talked about this a bit in the song scoring tutorial, we are recognizing harmonies, but we're still not triggering the style. Let's switch this off again. So we have the strings. Now if I switch off the right sound as well, the whole keyboard is silent. If I start now clicking this accompaniment button, ACMP, so like I told you, also up to the A, we're also recognizing sounds. And we're playing something that's weird. It sounds a little bit like a bass, some strings. So this is kind of a style pausing sound. I haven't quite figured it out, to be honest, if it's always taking the sounds from the style, because I don't really have strings in there. But it's kind of a way to maybe pre-listen. Sometimes we might not want that. So here's a little trick. If you press on the menu button and you go to style settings here, stop accompaniment is fixed. Now you can set this to style, Aha, now it's actually playing more like the sounds we used in the style. So the fixed one, I guess, is just a preset that overstays the same, thus fixed across all different styles and registrations. But we can also switch it off. So now it's completely silent. So now if I exit here and I put my right two on again, right two goes till here and then here's silence, right? Because we're triggering the style, we have the accompaniment on, but we selected to not hear anything when the style is not playing. So in order to play that style now, I selected the style variation or section A over here. I'm clicking between A and B. Again, I don't see it here, so that's one of the things missing. I think I noticed that in one of the last tutorials. And then here's the sync start. That's cool because we can start the style now whenever we press these keys. Now this is what I recorded last time in variation A. Another little hint, if I switch off the accompaniment and do sync start, we only get the drums because there's no chord information coming. But back to playing the string sound across the whole keyboard, which is selected here, could also switch it off, and no accompaniment, it still does a sync start by just starting to play anywhere. But it doesn't get any chord information, so only the drums are playing. Now this is something you can maybe use creatively at some point. There might be other ways of doing it, but maybe that's what you sometimes want. I'm gonna switch the accompaniment back on and sync start. And now listen what happens if I play anything but C major. So you notice a couple different things. The bass basically tries to follow these harmonies, but also I think there's kind of strange rapping going on, like it plays a little higher, a little lower. So obviously there's a couple things in the style that tells an instrument, and I'm talking about every single instrument, every single track of the style, in this case we only have the bass, to play within a certain range of high and low limits. It also tells it to follow our harmonies, at least in this case the root note of the harmony, and stuff like that. So there's many different settings, and I won't get into all of them now. Save this for later, what different ways we have, say, to trigger harmonies, to detect them. I can already give you a little hint. For bass, there's also a nice way to say when I'm actually pressing C major like this, it will actually put the G in the bass. So that's one option we could choose. And I can do all these inversions of C, where this might put the E in the bass. I think you can just see the note. I'm checking my display. And then this would just put the C in the bass. But in this normal setting, I believe I have it set to just do, let me just quickly check, split and fingering. It's actually on AI fingered. All right. I'm just going to put it on fingered. And just fingered on bass as well. Okay, let's just cover it quickly. So let's listen what that does. And let's do the fingered on bass. It's not so clear because we're not just playing one note in the bass, so okay, forget about this one. I always like to experiment a little bit, so please indulge me. I'm just going to save this quickly because I want to keep the fingered and not the AI. But let's do this in another tutorial, maybe where it's clearer that the bass is really following. Now in this case, the way I do my styles, honestly, compared to the styles you get in the presets and most styles you buy in addition, I usually don't really like to change with the harmonies, yeah? Because I think it's very hard. If you want to change with the harmonies, once you're in the style creator, let's go there, you would actually have to play everything in C. But you see, when we're recording, I showed you this last time, I'm actually playing the actual melody of the bass based on A, then I go to G, then I go to A again. So for me, it's very hard to imagine this in theory where I always play just C, right? And then I'm later playing the actual harmonies and it follows that. So the way I'm doing my songs, I have a certain scale in mind. And I usually just try to follow the scale of the original song I'm covering. So my approach is a little bit different and in a way more simple. But I think this gives you maybe much more fun with a quick start here. Especially if we're also playing melodies on top. You can see that we'll later add chords and pads. Those are all like chord based. And we could also add phrases. Now, keep in mind these parts can be used for anything, really. It's just like an idea. But when we go to, and we haven't covered this, I think we covered most of these tabs, we haven't covered this SFF edit. And that is really connected to freezing the scale now. Keep in mind, you want to make sure you're really on that current instrument. In this case, it's already the bass. That's fine. And you can already see something changing, the source root, play root, which is by default a little different for rhythm channels than for the bass. And when I click on this, this is what I was mentioning. It's usually in C major. You could also put this into any other scale, but then you have to record everything in that scale, again, if you want to follow. Now, I don't want to follow, and I'm not by any means pretending I understand the full complexity of this. I'm not. I just try to make it easier for me. So when I'm recording, you see in the bass, here's different variations, the root transpose, root fixed, guitar, and other things. So I just set this on fixed, so it doesn't follow what I'm playing. And then also for the melody, you want to make sure it's set to bypass. This just gives you a rough idea on what you could set. And then here, melodic minor, etc. I think this is very interesting if you want the harmonies or melodies to follow exactly what you're intending. You might imagine that we have C major, but my melody might include, say, a B flat to give it a little bit of like a blues feel. Then it wouldn't be correctly transposed. If you want to go to G, maybe you don't want the B flat, but another note. So in that case, you can then change that. But again, this seems very complex to me. Definitely advanced. So put the root on fixed, put the entity type on bypass, and switch off the bass. You only need to do this for the bass instrument. And you will see all of these different channels have different presets. So if I go to the next one, it's on root trans chord and the bass is not set. Right? So I would set that to fixed and that to bypass only. The next one, the root is already fixed. So it's all a little bit different, and so on. Now, I don't think it will save these settings, honestly, because we don't have anything on these channels yet. So it's a little bit maybe a wasted time to do it for everything. So that's why usually, Simone, I'm recording everything, and then in the very end, once I'm done with this section, I will then start freezing stuff here. So let's go back to bass. Just giving you kind of like an overview right now. So root fixed, bypass and off. And then high and low is also very interesting. I noticed this really mostly just applies to the bass. They're trying to be super smart here, Yamaha. They're actually setting the limit, the low limit for the bass to E0. Which, sorry, as you might know, a real bass, an acoustic bass, starts at E. So what happens, though, is if you want to do a nice arpeggiation, like, say, an octave arpeggiation, like this, and you're going below the E, it might actually not play that low D here. It will put it up, and you'll end up with... I had this happening to me, and it was very confusing. So if you have that problem, just put that low limit to C-2. But usually you might not have to worry about it. I don't worry about this in any of the other channels. I think All the other channels are automatically set to the lowest and highest note. And again, this is only relevant if you are trying to record, say, melodies or harmonies, and you want them in a specific inversion. So you don't want the F, say, to play like this, but down here, then you could, I guess, put the A or this F as the highest note, something like that. Again, it's not what I'm covering. I'm not trying to make it complicated. I'm just trying to give you a basic understanding of what's in here. So usually I would leave that at C major. I would leave that as is, exception of the bass. If I do play lower notes, you might want to put that all the way to the lowest limit. We covered this. Keep it all fixed. And now here's the last trick. I don't know exactly what every one of this means either. You see there's pitch shift to root, re-trigger. I think pitch shift was the one I want here. All right. And I'm in the wrong one, so let's go back to bass. Put this on pitch shift. Save it. Pressing home, and every time when I go out of the style editor, my microphone is off for some reason. It might be a bug. It's not coming back to the actual registration, which has the microphone set, but it's somehow doing something else. I don't know. Let's do it again. Even this bank, I changed that from the last time to just no longer have these banks here clawing the multipads, because we haven't covered that yet. I just put it to an empty bank. Even that is not recalled, as in the registration might be a bug. Okay, so let's try this again. So let's play the style, and since I was freezing everything, it should now no longer follow what I'm playing, and that's my intent, because I want to keep it easy and focus on playing along and maybe using the harmonies that I play here just to play, say, a left-hand sound. So this is working as we want it now. Yeah, so what I do in the end, very end, I do analyze again, or I do write down what harmonies I'm using. I'm still playing them, because honestly, it would also look a little odd in my videos if I wouldn't play anything. But oftentimes, I'm actually switching on a left sound. And what harmonies am I playing? Let's look back here. Let's go in here. Now, later we will do this differently and we'll actually put the harmonies in the song, like I showed you in the song scoring tutorial, and we'll see it in the score. So we have A, A, G, A. Okay. A, A, G, A. Let's just do the first part. Audio is back. Yeah, good. Okay. A, A, G, A. And switch left sound on. Yeah, so I'm playing along the style, but I'm not triggering different harmonies in the style. This is all pre-recorded to keep it simple, but I can still play along another left-hand sound. So I'm going to quickly check the time. All right, we're way over. So this is this part. See you in the next part.